All right, so after over a month in real time, these parts finally came in, lost in the mail forever. And that is the strobe and the resistor I have to attach to it because these guys aren't quite exactly. It's not, they don't make the originals anymore. This'll work, but if you plug it in as is, it's just gonna fry out and like. I don't know, a few days. But if you attach a resistor to it, it works for a while. Or so I'm told. I've already taken off the stylus so I don't mess anything up. And yeah, now I'm just gonna go ahead and put a cushion down over this to keep the tone arm from getting too mangled. And gonna open her back up. You. Guess we should also probably unplug this, huh? That's what a smart person would do. Wrong one. There we go. So, where'd I put my screwdriver? I need it. There you be. Okay, so just taking out the big screws. You can kind of see what I'm getting at from here. This isn't the best angle, but it's fine. Take the screws out. Step one. How many screws are there? Nah, I don't know. More than a couple. Say there is a grand total of seven that need to be removed. Again, it's been a minute. Guy goes off, and all we're looking for right now is this guy. That's our dude. And let me go ahead and unscrew this right quick. The only two screws we need to remove for this operation. Okay, so this is where our strobe's gonna end up being. It's coming through. These two holes. And I gotta make sure. I guess first things first, I need to figure out where I attach this resistor. So I'm gonna go do some internet research real quick and come back with that. Okay, after just a little bit of internet sleuthing, it turns out I need to replace this resistor, period, with one of these guys. We are going to do a little bit of testing first, though. The resistor needs to be 33 something something ohms, I guess. I don't know. But I do have a meter here, and we're gonna go ahead and check the resistance on the new one, and then we're gonna check the resistance on the old one. The old one should be 10. This thing should be 3300, I think. Find out. I mean, that's probably fine. Test one more of them. They gave me a pack. See if it pops up different. I'm sure it'll be fine. Yeah, let's go ahead and get this old guy out here and see what its story might be. Oh, yes. The siren call of this thing not being plugged in. Make sure if you're using a solder sucker or a vacuum of some kind that it's plugged in. That way, it works. That should do that. Let's try this again. Much better. Buddy, let's yeah. Tip on this guy is not quite large enough to get around all this. And also, you know what I'm doing? I'm doing the wrong fucking thing. Good God. Sure, I'm glad I record these things. That way you can see me fuck up in real time. It keeps me humble. Goodness gracious. All right. Probably going to stay put. I will resolder that before I'm done, though. All right. Let's get over here. You can see where the old bulb exploded on it. So, at least we know the bulb was bad, right? All right. You get it. I'm going to go ahead and test this, make sure it was 10. It's almost like maybe this thing is off by 2. No, there you go. Whatever. Unneeded now. And these guys, there's no direction they necessarily need to be put in, so I just need to install it. I don't think the strobe necessarily needs to be in a certain direction either. Not seeing anything on this indicating as such, so we're probably fine there. Like I've said probably multiple times in the beginning of this video that I started a billion months ago, I'm just learning. I'm freestyling here. I don't have a degree in this. I just learning. Okay. I'll check to make sure the Solder went all the way through when I'm done here. It's just that this is not a, it's not how I normally solder, you know, holding this with one hand, but that's what I have to do right at this moment. All right. Not the best job. There we go. Looking a little better. Try it again. I'm just heating the solder up and pushing the resistor through a little bit more. I should have done this before I started applying solder, but it's not what I did. Almost like this is real hot or something. Whatever. That's fine for me. I don't care. I'm keeping this. I'm not selling it. I don't care. But let's go ahead and get the wires soldered back in correctly. Correctly. And just get them soldered back in, I should say. There. Lift that pad, Rob. Do not lift that fucking pad. Okay. It's my mantra for today. Don't lift that pad. I think you can actually still see this. It's wonderful for cell phone use. At some point, I'll have a camera that's on a tripod or whatever and do this a little bit better. For our purposes right now, this is delightful. All right, here we go. All right, that's fine. Should be it there. Gonna clip off the ends on this resistor and I think we're good to go. All right. So let's put this guy away. Oh, we're not done yet. Good God. Ah! I guess it doesn't really do much unless I install this thing, huh? Oh, guys, I didn't say I was any good at this. I hope that you're not too disappointed in me. All right, this, however, we are going to do a couple of things. This hole isn't open yet, and there's not enough solder here for me to get it that way. So I'm putting a little bit of this terrible, terrible flux, but it helps. I'm gonna put solder back onto that hole, and then we'll use the solder sucker to remove all of it. That way it, I'm not fighting and putting too much pressure on this pad, because again, there will be no lifted pads today. That is the mantra. That is what... Sorry. Sorry. He said to no one. The Alpha. There we go. Yeah. The smart move would have been just to desolder the whole thing, put it down onto the mat there, and his proper soldering technique, but I don't want him. That should be fine. Make sure this guy's clear. It's pretty good. But I am going to clean it ever so slightly. All right. Let's do it. There we go. Now we can install this without too much trub. And do a better job on this one than I did with getting this resistor in. Which I might still fix. God, these leads are made of nothing. This... just some very soft metal. Go. Now I feel comfortable doing that. Put these little buddies. Okay. There we go. Good enough for jazz. Let's go ahead and get this back where it should be. And yeah, we'll come back, turn it on, see if it explodes or anything. All right, moment of truth as it were. If this thing works, then we have ourselves a perfectly good, an operational Technics 3200 with a really tiny spider crawling across it. I don't know if you can see him, but he's going real fast. Oh. Where you go, little buddy? Where are you off to? And we're almost the spooky season. We'll let him live. Come on, thing. Oh, hell yeah. All right. I'll take you down this ways. Let's get our... there we go. So that's our 33. But our 45 is being a little bit of a butt. Doesn't quite want to sink. Okay, so if memory serves on the power board, there are two... trim pots that are I can use to adjust the 45 speed. So we're going to take this thing back apart and adjust that and see if we can get this thing synced back up. Okay, got it open again, and yeah, here are our trim pots.
And this one's for 45, this one's for 33. 45 is what we're having issues with. If I go clockwise, it'll slow down. I think that we need to be ever so slightly faster. So I'm just going to give this a little nudge with one hand, there we go. And yeah, let's put it back together and see if that fixed it. Okay, we've got it put back together here. Let's see if we can get the speed controls tuned. All right, so we're at 45 currently. Bingo. All right, good to go on that one. Make sure 33 is still looking good. Man, we are solid. All right, let's see if our boy Bobby Bland here is cool and doesn't get us copyright struck. As you can hear, there's nothing going on in the background, so there's no hum. So let's make sure that everything still sounds okay. Stopping still works. And that is an operational Technics SL-3200. Do I need to change the needle? You betcha. But for our purposes here, this is an operational turntable. Woo! Okay, well, thanks for watching. If you made it all the way through, I have plenty of other turntables I need to fix. So if you enjoy turntable diagnostic by a layman, then I guess just you wait. All right, yeah, have a good one. Bye. Hey, just a little follow-up. So remember in the first video how that one record was no bueno. Well, I'll have you know, good old Bobby Bland does not give a toot. Thanks, Bobby. You're a good dude. I'm gonna return to upload on this. All right, well, if you made it this far into the video, you'll understand what I'm talking about. So, cool. Thanks for watching.